Alrighty, everybody, welcome back to the St. Paul Handicapable Ministry here on YouTube. February the 24th, we're into a new year, 2024. One of the favorite songs that we sing is He's Got the Whole World in His Hands. Who's got the whole world in His hands? God's got the whole world in His hands. And I love this when we have an opportunity to go out on the floor when we have our in-person worship services and be able to lift up some of the people personally who God has in His hands. Take it away, Jesse.
He got the whole world in His hands. He's got the whole wide world in His hands. He's got the whole world in His hands. He's got the whole world in His hands. He got my good friend Tommy here in His hands. He got my good friend Tommy here in His hands. He got my good friend Tommy here in His hands. He got the whole world in His hands. He's got a Christine and Dale here in His hands. He's got a Christine and Dale here in His hands. He got a Christine and Dale here in His hands. He got the whole world in His hands. He's got Tanya, Yvonne, and Betty in His hands. He got a Tanya, Yvonne, and Betty in His hands. He got a Tanya, Yvonne, and Betty in His hands. He got the whole world in His hands. He's got Virginia, Kathy, and Chris here in His hands. He's got Virginia, Kathy, and Chris here in His hands. He's got Virginia, Kathy, and Chris here in His hands. He's got the whole world in His hands. He got the whole table here in His hands. He's got the whole table here in His hands. He got the whole table here in His hands. He got the whole world in His hands. He got this table and that table, these tables too. All of our children are you new. And also we have parked over here. He got the whole world in His hands. He got my little bitty children, Danny too. He's got my little bitty children, Danny too. He's got my little bitty children, Danny too. He's got the whole world in His, the whole world in His, the whole world in His hand. Woo-hoo, great job, Danny. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Woo-hoo.
Oh, one of the most, celebration times that we have is when we celebrate birthdays. This is a beautiful clip that was taken. We had a birthday celebration. You can just see from the look on her face just how much it meant to her. And our joy song, we take our offerings, and also God and Jesus loves us all the time. Okay, Jesse, let's get some good tunes in here.
Maybe you've already had one, you got one coming up before next week. Oh, we got a birthday cup, birthday. Look, you got a birthday. Come on up here. All right, big hand. All right, we're going to sing happy birthday now, okay? You're so beautiful tonight. We love you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. God bless you. Happy birthday to you. Woo! Wasn't that fantastic? Happy birthday. You're the most beautiful birthday girl of the day. Beautiful. Thank you. Okay. All right. Thank you so much. Okay. That's wonderful. Great. Okay. We got the joy song. Renee can, let's see. Can you help gather up a few people to help take the offering up? Maybe Ola's back there. Maybe Ola could do that. There we go. We'll get a few that are going on. Denise, here are the baskets up here. We love to sing the joy song. We love to give praise and thanksgiving to God for this wonderful ministry. Okay, you ready? I got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart, down in my heart, down in my heart. I got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart, down in my heart to stay. I've got the light of Jesus down in my heart, down in my heart, down in my heart. I've got the light of Jesus down in my heart, down in my heart to stay. I've got the peace of Jesus down in my heart, down in my heart, down in my heart. I've got the peace of Jesus down in my heart, down in my heart to stay. Let's get that over. I've got the love of Jesus down in my heart, down in my heart, down in my heart. I've got the love of Jesus down in my heart, down in my heart to stay. All right, way to go to your old handy announcement. Gail wants us to remember that God loves us all the time, and primarily just on Wednesday nights. Every day? Every second? Every second of every minute of every hour of every day of every week. Every week of every month of every year. He loves us throughout eternity, and I pray I've made myself quite clear. Woohoo! We are so thankful.
Tonight's spotlight is on Dale and Christine. When we started putting on the spotlights, and I think we actually had 49 that are posted right now on YouTube, you could go in there and find any one of them that we had. Dale and Christine had more views than any other person. And the reason they had so many views, because of the beautiful dance that they did. Dale and Christine, take it away and show us just how beautiful a couple you are when you get on the dance floor.
The Caldwells, Chuck, Christine, Dale, and Cindy are another of our longtime members. Here are several examples of their participation in handy activities over the years. Christine and Dale's legacy is during their wedding dance at Handicapable's annual talent show. Their dance always brings the attending crowd to its feet as they do the final scene, where they lovingly give each other a kiss. For several years now, this dynamic duo has been entertaining us in this fashion. Dale is also a lover of big 16-wheeler rigs. Hear that horn blow! Dale and Christine, we love you and are so thankful you are part of our Handicapable family.
Another spotlight, because it's getting back to that time of year, in years past when Bill had moved back to Canada with his dear wife, Joan, they were used to try to make a trip in February. And so I'm not sure whether Bill's going to be able to make it this February or not. But anyway, we wanted to be able to spotlight Bill and show what he meant to this ministry when he started it back in October of 1997. Here we go.
Bill Fritz and his lovely wife, Joan, arrived to St. Paul in the summer of 1997 when he was appointed one of our associate pastors. Upon their arrival, I welcomed Bill and Joan at the Friendship Sunday School class, which I was attending at the time. This class, composed mostly of couples in their 40s, 50s, and 60s, was our church's largest adult Sunday School class at the time. It was so good to reunite with my good friends I had originally met in 1994 when Bill introduced his Handicapable ministry to our church. Bill is a go-getter. One of his primary goals upon arriving on our church campus was to launch a special needs ministry such as the one he had started in Canada. One day, being full of vim and vigor, he burst into the office of our senior pastor's office, Dr. Tom Farmer Jr. When Bill starts talking, anyone within shouting distance must take heed and listen intently to his message. Bill's message was loud and clear. He had a game plan all outlined to start the St. Paul Handicapable Ministry. Bill pleaded his case, and Dr. Farmer, who was totally sold out on the concept, told Bill that according to the organizational structure of our church, he would need to present his plan to the church's ministry board for its approval. A special meeting of the ministry board was arranged. Bill received the full support of the ministry board to launch St. Paul Church's newest ministry, the St. Paul Handicapable Ministry. With approval in hand, Bill began preparing all types of supporting documentation to help educate parents, volunteers, group home leaders, and others to gain a better understanding of how to work with God's special people. The next step of the launch plan was to gather a few people who had special needs family members and or servant hearts that might be interested in participating and serving within the ministry. This, my friends, is the beginning of the launch of the St. Paul Handicapable Ministry, which today is in the middle of its 26th year of offering services and social activities for God's special people.
Jesus has promised to us, Philippians 4, verse 13, in Him who is the source of my strength, I have strength for everything. That is so powerful. Never forget that gold nugget. All right, let's get ready and go to the Lord in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we have so much to be thankful for at St. Paul. Just so thankful for the opportunity we've had in these 26 plus years of having ministry here for the special needs community, not only of Pinellas County, but now when we're able to reach people outside the boundaries of Pinellas County, in some places in different states, and even in different parts of the world, we can tell the others what a joy it is to be a part of this wonderful ministry, how we're all seeking to become better followers of you. Father, we just are so thankful for all the people through the years who have made this ministry what it is today. Continue to pour your blessings on all of us. Continue to bless our nation, O Father, and just continue to bless our church that we love so much. For we ask these things in Christ's name. Amen. What we're going to be looking at again today, we're into our third series on the why and how do we pray. Tonight's scripture is from Psalm 145, verse 18. The Lord is near to all who call upon Him, to all who call upon Him in truth. I love so many of the Psalms and everything has such powerful verses in there. All right, we're going to be looking at the why and how do we pray. We mentioned our last week, and I want to mention again this week, you can see the hand of God that's reaching down. We know that God is present with us all the time. You can see the smiling face of Jesus, the beautiful picture that was painted by G. You can see Bill Fritz from the pulpit of the church when he was here and did some of the preaching here many, many years ago. And you see our faithful, handicapable member Todd Smiles, who for many, many years helped lead us in prayer. All right, we've been talking about congregational care and what Jack had done to provide congregational care for that. One of the things that I always remember about Jack was his patience. He had so much patience. You could just see that he was such a true follower. And one of the things that he did, that he was so faithful, that he would go out on his own, he and Joni would, and go and visit with some of the older members of the church that he had made a connection with when he was here in the very early years of his ministry here. Jack, we love you and Joni so much. All right, what are some of our needs for prayer? For forgiveness, we need to pray for healing, for guidance, for strength, and to give thanks for answered prayer. Tonight we're going to be looking at guidance. This is our good friend, Tom. Tom, for many, many years, was a faithful member of Handicapable Ministry. And Tom was blind. He was so smart. One of the things, the character traits that I loved about Tom, all he would say, Horton, give me your birthday, and just tell him what the year, the month was and the date was, and he could remember it years later. I don't recall ever having to tell him the year, but he would knew when the month came up and the day came up, he would knew whose birthday it was. But also, Tom being blind, he needed someone to help guide him along. He had so much help from his other consumers there that were part of Crossroads while Tom was living there. And his faithful friend Tyler used to guide Tom along when he came to Handicapable and went on different trips that we took. All right, in closing, like I've mentioned time and time again, it's the fact that try to ask God to grant us His peace, His strength, His power, His love, and His encouragement. Tonight we're going to be looking at grant us His power. You can see the picture right there of Jesus. You can see the cross. You know, God had the power, even though Jesus was put to the cross, God had the power. And so many people thought when Jesus had died at the cross, that was the end of Jesus. That was the end of the story. But no, that was not the case. Because of the power of God, He saw to it that on the third day that Jesus arose from the dead. And He went back out among the people, went back out among the people that were there. So we can always count on, if we ask for power from God, He's going to hear our prayers. Now, that doesn't mean we're going to get the power that we're specifically asking for. But you know, you can be assured that one of the things that I think that we're asking for, God, when we need your power, which is most of the time, please grant us that. All right, the three things we need to do to become better followers of Jesus. We need to follow Jesus, read, believe, and act on His word. And yes, pray for strength and guidance. I hope all of you, I think that right now, that we've got close to 320 different type of videos we put on YouTube. Hopefully, if you have not subscribed already, be sure and subscribe to YouTube. We want you to be a part not only of our YouTube services, but we also want you to be a part of in-person services that we're having here every Wednesday. Start 6:30, go to 7:30, St. Paul United Methodist Church at the corner of Highland and Rosary. God bless you, take care, and never forget that God loves us more than we could ever imagine.